Good day, everyone. Glad to see you on our channel. In this video, we will discuss the soon-to-be-launched Ethereum 2.0 and its key features. We will also compare it to Polkadot, a blockchain called one of the Ethereum killers. Can Polkadot really outmatch Ethereum 2.0? Let's find out. What is Ethereum? Ethereum is an open-source blockchain platform launched in 2015. Now it's one of the most popular blockchains for dApps and NFT development. Ethereum has its own native currency called Ether. In August 2022, its market capitalization was $198 billion, falling short of Bitcoin only. Being the second most popular blockchain, Ethereum has a massive community and well-developed ecosystem. The platform runs on a proof-of-work consensus algorithm that provides security and stability. However, it results in some tangible drawbacks. First, Ethereum suffers from lack of scalability, since each node in the network has to process each transaction. Consequently, it leads to low transaction speed, allowing to process only up to 30 transactions per second, which is very slow for such a giant blockchain. Yet, since Ethereum has to handle 1 million transactions per day, the transaction fees are very high. Depending on the congestion, the fee can range from $1 to $200. And one more considerable drawback is high energy consumption. Ethereum requires 112 terawatt hours a year, which is equal to the Netherlands' energy demand. Is there a way to handle these pain points? The Ethereum team is now working on its upgrade, promising to tackle all the platform's downsides. So, what is Ethereum 2.0? Ethereum 2.0 will run on the proof-of-stake consensus algorithm and leverage sharding technology. As a result, the blockchain will become more eco-friendly, with energy consumption decreased by 99% in comparison with the proof-of-work demand. Besides, Ethereum 2.0 is estimated to be able to process up to 100,000 transactions per second, which is much faster than the capacity of the original platform. Speaking about the transaction cost, no exact numbers are yet available, but it's estimated that Ethereum 2.0 transaction fee will be lower as less gas will be required. And finally, the platform will greatly improve its scalability as Ethereum 2.0 will use shard and SAD chains. The estimated upgrade's release date is 2022-2023. Now let's move to Polkadot. Polkadot is a blockchain and cryptocurrency that originated in 2020. An interesting fact is that Polkadot's founder is Gavin Wood, an Ethereum co-founder. As of August 2022, the blockchain's market cap is almost $9 billion. The platform was launched to solve the major pain points of Ethereum and aims to be more efficient in terms of transaction speed, cost, energy consumption, and scalability. To achieve it, Polkadot uses hybrid consensus protocol and parachains, thus processing several transactions simultaneously. The blockchain handles 1,000 transactions per second and does it for free. Polkadot is also very electricity efficient, using 0.8 gigawatt hours a year. It is equivalent to the daily energy consumption of 170 UK citizens. So, what is better, Ethereum 2.0 or Polkadot? There is no definite answer of which blockchain is the best in this Polkadot versus Ethereum 2.0 comparison. Both allowing for improved scalability and high transaction throughput, they still differ in such important characteristics as architecture, staking mechanics, governance, interoperability, and security. Let's take a closer look at the differences between these blockchains. Ethereum 2.0 has a main chain called Beacon Chain, and Shards, each being a blockchain with the Ethereum WASM interface. There are also sidechains, which interact with chains that are not under the finality protocol of the platform. Meanwhile, Polkadot's core is the relay chain, responsible for coordinating the platform's connected parachains. The parachains can have their own consensus algorithms and tokens, as well as define their own logic and interface. Thus, Ethereum 2.0 caters better for the projects built within its ecosystem, while Polkadot allows to build completely customizable platforms and effortlessly interact with projects on other blockchains. Regarding consensus algorithms, Ethereum 2.0 is a proof-of-stake network with groups of random validators assigned to a particular shard block. Ethereum blocks are finalized based on specific time intervals in 6-12 minutes. In its turn, Polkadot leverages nominated proof-of-stake to select validators. Prime goal is to ensure fair representation. To achieve it, Polkadot assigns slots to validators proportional to their nominations. They finalize batches of blocks based on availability in 12-60 seconds. Speaking about the governance, there is still uncertainty on how it will work on Ethereum 2.0. Currently, in order to make a decision, the platform applies off-chain government procedures such as GitHub discussions. In contrast, Polkadot applies on-chain governance with all the proposals passing through a public referendum. The outcome is determined by the majority of tokens. From the interoperability point of view, Ethereum 2.0 loses to Polkadot, as it's very difficult to send data from Ethereum to other chains, while Polkadot allows to connect different chains and make seamless cross-chain transactions. Lastly, let's touch upon the security issue. Polkadot relies on shared security, meaning that all parachains benefit from the economic security provided by the relay chain validators. Thus, it's nearly impossible to attack a parachain. Ethereum 2.0 also strives to ensure high security standards. Ethereum's shift to the proof-of-stake algorithm itself makes the blockchain more secure. It is achieved with the help of the mechanism destroying validators' staked coins in case they attack the network. Ethereum 2.0 will also have an increased number of validators, at least 16,384. This will help avoid coordinated threats such as 51% attacks. All in all, Polkadot is already up and running, while Ethereum 2.0 is still in development. Yet we can't underestimate Ethereum's strong community of developers and its vast ecosystem, thriving even despite the scalability and interoperability challenges. Which blockchain should you choose for your project? When choosing whether to go for Ethereum 2.0 or Polkadot, you should start with identifying your project's goals. If you don't require control over the economics of your system or you need interoperability with some other project from the Ethereum ecosystem, then Ethereum 2.0 will be the best option. On the other hand, if you want to have full control of the environment, storage, and economics, and your application needs higher transaction throughput, then go for Polkadot. It is also a perfect choice if you require integration across multiple blockchains. All in all, Ethereum 2.0 aims to be the base for DeFi projects and smart contracts. Meanwhile, Polkadot is focused on helping developers build their own blockchains and integrating these blockchains with each other. What do you think about this Ethereum 2.0 versus Polkadot competition? Which blockchain do you find the most efficient? Share your opinion in the comments below. Smash that like button and subscribe to our channel not to miss a single episode. For more information, visit PixelPlex blog, where we post weekly articles about blockchain and other promising technologies. See you in the next episode. Bye!